before we will see that what is the characteristic function. Now let's move on to the next concept, that will be the properties of the characteristic function. We already know the formula for the characteristic function as well as the some simple proof for the characteristic function. Okay, the first property be the Ix of omega, where omega is equal to 0, that will be equal to Ix of 0, that will be equal to 1. Okay, this was the proof we have to be solved. Or this was the first property. We already know the formula for the characteristic function. Ix of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. This was the formula for the characteristic function. Though omega lies in between minus infinity to plus infinity range. Omega range be the in between minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay? So you already know the formula for the Ix of omega. So, phi x of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. So, in place of omega, we place omega with 0, what will happen? So, this will become the expectation of e power j into 0 into x. So, this will be the expectation of e power 0, this will become the 1. So, you already know the expectation of constant, that will be the constant. So here 1 will be the constant. So here expectation of constant will be constant. This will be the phi x of 0. Okay. That will be equal to phi x of omega, where in case of omega, replace omega to 0. This was the first proof. Next proof be the second proof. Second proof. Phi x of omega, where omega is equal to 0, less than or equal to, okay, less than or equal to 1. Okay, this was the proof. Or Ix of 0, Ix of 0, so that will be the less than or equal to 1. Okay, so that we can take the 1. So this will be the 1. This was our proof. We have to check whether it will be possible or not. Okay. And you can solve this. You just have to be told that what will be the formula for the characteristic function? Ix of omega, where omega is equal to 0, but deep expectation of e power j omega x. You already know e power expectation of e power j omega x, that will be the minus infinity to infinity. The fx of x into e power j omega x into d. Yes. Now, what you have to do is, so this be the modulus. So, what you have to do is, you already know what will be the formula for the modulus of x y. That will be the greater than or equal to modulus of x into modulus of y. This was the formula. Now, if you want to apply the modulus here, what will happen? So, modulus of phi x of omega, where omega is equal to 0, that will be the integration of minus infinite to infinite modulus of fx of x into e power j omega x into dx. Okay? So, here you can see this be in the form of modulus of x, this be the x and this be the y. How you can write? That will be the modulus of x into modulus of y. Okay, so whenever if you want to write from equal to the here that modulus of sine, you have to be directly substitute this formula. So if you want to take in the, for example, in case of greater than, if I want to take the less than, so this will become the less than or equal to. This is also possible. Whether I am equal to modulus of x into modulus of y. But in this property, we are mainly focusing on less than or equal to. So we are taking the less than or equal to. So here this will become the less than or equal to integration of minus infinity infinity modulus of f(x) of x into modulus of e power j omega x into dx. So this will be the modulus of pi x of omega, where omega is equal to 0. So here pi x of omega, where omega is equal to 0. So if you want to substitute the minus infinity infinity modulus of fx of x, so substitute the in place of omega, replace omega with 0, and here also replace omega with 0, this will become the e power j into 0 into x into dx. So this will become the modulus of pi x of 0, where omega is equal to 0, less than or equal to minus infinity to infinity modulus of fx of x. We already know e power 0, that will be the one into dx. So this will be the less than or equal to, so this will be the density function, the area under the density function, that will be equal to 1. So this will be the less than or equal to 1. So here this will be the ix of 0, where omega is equal to 0. So here this will be the phi x of omega, where omega is equal to 0. So this was your answer, second property. Okay, so if you want to write for the third property, okay, what will be the third property? Phi x of omega is continuous. Ix of omega is continuous. They will be given the range. Range omega will be between minus infinity to infinity. Okay, this was the third property. So if you want to solve the third property, how you can solve? You already know the characteristic equation formula, but be the modulus of pi x of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. Again, here where omega, that will be equal to 0. Okay. So here if you see, whenever omega be the continuous, whenever the omega be the continuous means, at that case only, e power j omega x is also be the continuous. Okay? Whenever both this omega as well as the e power j omega x, that will be the continuous. That means the omega will be the range from the minus infinity to the plus infinity. Okay? Then omega is continuous. Means where whenever e power j omega x is also continuous. Okay. Next, we can see the other property. So, phi, fourth property, phi x of minus omega that will be equal to phi x star of minus omega. Okay, that's the formula. Sorry, this was the property we have to be solved. Okay, have you can solve this property? You already know formula for V, phi x of omega, phi x of omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. Now what you have to do is replace omega with minus omega. What will happen? Replace omega with minus omega. So here this will become the phi x of minus omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j into minus omega into x. So this will become the expectation of e power minus j omega x. So this be the phi x of minus omega will be equal to expectation. If you want to write the e power j omega x, whole conjugate. Okay, if you want to just put the conjugate, you can't make the minus symbol there. Okay, so if you remove this conjugate, whenever you have to be remove this conjugate, there you have to replicate the minus symbol. Okay, so this will become the phi x star of minus omega. So this be the phi x of minus omega. Okay, this was the proof. Next, you can see the another proof. Okay, next property be the fifth property. Phi x conjugate of minus omega that will be equal to phi of omega. Okay, this was the property we have to be solved. You already know how you can solve this. Phi x of omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. This was the formula. Now what we have to do is here replace the omega with minus omega. Replace omega with minus omega. Then so here phi x of minus omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j into minus omega into x. So this be the expectation of e power minus j omega x. Okay. So now what you have to do is you have to apply the conjugate phi x square of minus omega that will be equal to expectation of e power minus j omega x whole conjugate. So whenever you have to apply the conjugate, you may need to put the minus symbol here. So this will be the expectation of e power j omega x whole conjugate. If you remove this conjugate, in the domain you will see the minus symbol here. If you put the conjugate, you don't need to put the minus symbol here. So this will become the phi of omega. Okay, so this will be the phi of omega star. So this will be the phi of minus omega that will be equal to phi of omega constant. Okay, next you can see the sixth property. So it's going to be the characteristic function of y is equal to ax plus b is phi y of omega that will be equal to e power j omega b into pi x of a omega. Again, where a and b be the real constants. Where capital A, small x or small a, and small b, b bar, real constants. Real constants. Again, so you already know the formula for the characteristic function, that will be the Ix of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. Now, in this property, what you have to do is, you have to do the replace x with y. What will happen? Replace x with y. Then, so, pi y of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega y. So, here expectation of e power j omega, what will be the y? Y be the ax plus b. So here this will become the expectation of e power j omega ax. So e power a plus b, that will be the e power a into e power b. So this will be the e power j omega b. So this will become the expectation of e power j omega ax into expectation of e power j omega b. So here expectation of e power j omega b the constant, expectation of constant be the constant, that will become the e power j omega b into expectation of e power j omega a x. So this will become the e power j omega b into expectation of, in place of e power j omega x, e power j omega x, what will be the formula? That will be the pi x of omega. So here in place of omega, what will be the term added? The constant term, that will be the a will be added. So that will become the pi x of a omega. The meaning will be constant term. So here pi y of omega, that will be equal to e power j omega b into pi x of a omega. This was the important property for the characteristic function. Now let's see the another property for the characteristic function. So, second property. Pi x1 plus x2 of omega, that will be equal to pi x1 of omega into pi x2 of omega. Okay, this was the proof, this was the property. You have to be solved this property. So here, how you can solve this property? You already know the formula for the characteristic function, that will be the Ix of omega, the replacement expectation of e power j omega. Then, now what you have to do is replace the x with x1 plus x2. Replace x with x1 plus x2 then. So here this will be the I of x1 plus x2 of omega, that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x1 plus x2. So this will be the expectation of e power j omega. So here also e power a plus b, that will be e power a into e power b. So here e power j omega x1 into e power j omega x2. So now we have to apply the expectation for this. Expectation of e power j omega x1 into expectation of e power j omega x2. So this be then phi of x1 plus x2 of omega. So this be then phi of x1 of omega into this beta phi into x2 of omega. So this beta phi of x1 plus x2 of omega. This was the proof. This was the proof. Okay, now we'll see the other proof. So this will be the last proof. Eighth proof. Phi of C omega that will be equal to phi C x of omega. Okay. This was the property we have to be solving. Here we already know formula for the characteristic function. So the beta phi x of omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j omega x. Okay, so replace omega with c omega. Okay, c omega. Then so phi x of c omega that will be equal to expectation of e power j into c omega x, c omega into x. So this be the phi of, so constant be the c x of omega. So this be the phi x of omega. C omega. Okay, in this way we can solve the number of properties based on the characteristic function. In the previous examination paper, in this examination point of view, these 8 properties is more than enough. Okay, in the next class, we will try to see the what will be the minimum generating functions and what will be the important properties for the minimum generating functions. Okay, if you really like this video, please like my video, share my video, as well as the subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.